So the next part of the discussion here is that is molecular mass, molecular mass and calculation of molecular mass, mass of molecule, molecules or compounds. So here, first of all, let us understand the meaning of molecular mass. What is molecular mass? We go to the molecular mass. It is the relative amount of, it is the relative amount of mass of molecules or compounds which are heavier than, that means number of times, it is the relative amount of molecular mass of molecules or compounds, we can say, and it is number of times molecule or compound is heavier than 1/12 of the carbon isotope. 1/12 of the carbon isotope. Now, when you are going for the calculation of molecular mass, you should also know what is the meaning of chemical formula or chemical composition. If you go for chemical formula, if you want to calculate the molecular mass, you should know. If you want to calculate the molecular mass, you should know the chemical formula, the meaning of chemical formula. A chemical formula is made up of symbols and subscripts. Symbol gives the type of element, type of elements, and subscript gives the number of atoms and its types of the molecule. If you are taking H2O, this H2O contains symbol. In H2O we have two symbols. One is, we have H is one, there are two different types of waters. One is hydrogen and one is oxygen. Here hydrogen, H represents hydrogen element and O represents oxygen element. Now if you take the whole composition of water, then it is very clear that we have H2O. H2O means H base 2O, H2O of 1. Here this 2 and 1 are nothing but, this 2 and 1 are the subscripts. So here if you want to calculate the molecular formula of the different compounds or molecules, suppose for example calculation of molecular mass. If you take the calculation of molecular mass, take the calculations of molecular mass of carbon dioxide, say carbon dioxide and water and H2O. You take carbon dioxide, for example, you take carbon dioxide. If you're taking carbon dioxide, we are coming here, we can know that this carbon dioxide is made up of one into carbon plus there are two oxygen, so 2 into oxygen. So if that is the case, then what we are able to understand, one carbon means the atomic mass of each carbon is 12 units, so therefore 1 into 12 plus the atomic mass of each oxygen, there are two oxygens, each oxygen atomic mass is 16 16 2 are 32, that is 2 into 16 which is equal to 12 plus 32 which is equal to 44 units. is the atomic mass of carbon dioxide. Likewise, you go for H2O, it contains one oxygen, it contains one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms. So what you are noticing here, one oxygen means atomic mass of one oxygen is 16 units, and there are two hydrogens, one hydrogen atomic mass is 1 unit, so there are 2 hydrogens, so 2 into 1 which is equal to 16 plus 02 which is equal to 18 units. So likewise you can calculate the molecular mass of different species. Suppose if I am taking the molecule, and the molecular mass, if I am taking molecule and molecular mass, we take molecular mass randomly. If I am selecting some molecules, we can take HCl for example is a molecule, its molecular mass is 36.5 units. You take you can take NH3 ammonia, its molecular mass, if you take NH3 ammonia, its molecular mass is 14 plus each nitrogen atomic mass. Each nitrogen atomic mass is 14 units and 3 hydrogens, 3 units, 14 plus 3, 17 units. So 17.0 units is the molecular mass of ammonia. Then likewise you can go for SO2. Go for SO2, one sulfur atomic mass is 32 units and two oxygens, one oxygen atomic mass is 16, 16 to 32. So 32 plus 32, it is going to become, that is 64 units, 0.0 units. So likewise you can take methane. In methane also we can calculate the molecular mass, one carbon atomic mass is 12 units and there are 4 hydrogens, so 4 units. So we can write here, that is 16.0 units and so on. So you can calculate as many number of molecules as possible in the case of molecular mass of different species. So now let us take one question here. That is, suppose if the question is given to you like this, calculate the molecular mass of a H2SO4 and another one is B Na2SO4 sodium sulfate. So here A H2SO4 is it is sulfuric acid, it is a strong acid. So actually when you are going for sulfuric acid, there are different atoms present in it. The different types of atoms present in this sulfuric acid are hydrogen we have, sulfur we have and oxygen we have. But actually if you take the number of hydrogens, there are two hydrogens. If you take for sulfuric acid you have two hydrogens, two into hydrogen, we have two hydrogens, then one into sulfur, then we have four oxygens are there, so four into oxygen. And we know that the atomic mass of hydrogen is equal to 1.0 unit, atomic mass of sulfur is equal to, that is 32.0 units, then for oxygen, atomic mass of oxygen is equal to, that is 16.0 units. So what we have to do here is, because there are two hydrogens, so I am taking here, so the molecular mass, I'll put it like this. So I'm calculating here, there are two hydrogens, so 2 into hydrogen is equal to 2 into atomic mass of hydrogen is 1.0. then you go for sulfur, there is only one sulfur, so 1 into sulfur is equal to 1 into 32.0. then there are 4 oxygens, so 4 into oxygen is equal to 4 into 16.0. so this, upon simplification, you're going to get, this is 2.0. here you are going to get 2.0, then here you are going to get 32.0, and here you are going to get again 64.0. so mark 0 here, so this is going to become 98.0. so therefore the molecular mass of H2SO4 is equal to 98.0 units is the answer. Likewise, you go for sodium sulfate. If you are going for sodium sulfate, now go for B, sodium sulfate. When you are going for sodium sulfate, again same thing we have to do, take the number of sodium atoms, number of sulfur atoms and number of oxygen atoms. Take 2 sodiums, so I am going to mark it here as 2 into sodium. Of course Na2SO4 is called sodium sulfate. Sodium sulfate, so 2 into sodium, we have 2 into sodium, sodium atomic mass is 23.0, so 2 into 23.0, then we have 1 sulfur, 1 into sulfur is equal to 1 into 32.0, then we have 4 oxygen, so 4 into oxygen is equal to 4 into 16.0, so this is 46.0, this is 32.0, then this is 64.0, so 0, this is 10, 12, 12 means this is 1, 1 means 7, 7 plus 3, 10, 142, 7, 3, 10, 10 plus 4, 14, so 142.0, so therefore molecular mass of Na2SO4 is equal to 142.0 units. 142.0 units is the answer.